So as we keep on moving, L100 Radio Show. And right now in the studio, we've got a guest. He's a hip-hop MC representing the world to the fullest. In the past few years, we've seen him collaborate with big artists from the independent hip-hop scene. And his album releases, The Wolf King and Self-Isolation, haven't just been really music releases. They've also been like musical journeys as well, which deal with a few personal issues, as well as showing this guy's incredible rhyme skills. So welcome to the L100.
Big up, Mayav, man. Pleasure to be here as always. Yes, I am very good,
Mr. Felcon, a.k.a. Con Lennon.
A.k.a. The Wolf King.
A.k.a. The Wolf King. Now, this is the third time.
The trilogy is in effect.
So a lot of people who've listened to the shows or my other shows in the past will probably be a little bit familiar. But for our new listeners, if you like, can you just tell them a little bit about you, how you started and sort of your earlier influences?
Well, it mainly come from like leaving school, do you know what I mean? I didn't know what I wanted to do. Obviously, growing up, I had a stutter. I was like, what can counteract having a stutter? Let's rhyme words as fast as you can. And then it all spun from there, do you know what I mean? Then obviously, Hush Hush Media, Nick, meeting Rosh, meeting you,
yeah,
L100, then so on, so on.
So what year would it have been that you first sort of put pen to paper, if you like, to start actually writing your own lyrics down?
2011, so it would have been 10 years strong now.
That long?
10 years, yeah.
Wow. And what was your first show? Do you remember your first show?
Supporting Jamie Broad. Was my first ever show, 2014.
Was it, yeah?
Before Jacaranda, it might have been before Jacaranda Shorts.
Okay.
In fact, it was Bumper, before Bumper Shorts.
Wow. Now you are going back, yeah. You are going back. So, your influences then, musically, I mean, was he a particular artist or artists that got you into hip-hop first? I mean, was it your love for hip-hop first, or was it...
Yeah, it was my love, do you know what I mean? I remember being like 6 years old and my mum buying... R. Chris, Slim Shady LP, Eminem LP.
Really?
Being forced to listen to it with headphones in, and then being like, I like this. And then walking through town in Birkenhead and buying a Young Jeezy CD.
Oh, yeah,
and
yeah.
I was like,
in fact, I remember you telling me a story about someone in Birkenhead.
Selling CDs, HMV, something down. He's like, do you want to buy a CD? I was like, that looks good. Just played Def Jam. I was like, I know Young Jeezy. I was like, yeah. And then come from there.
And... obviously, your rhyme style. I mean, how would you describe what your rhyme style is?
It's fluid. It's not solid. It's ever changing.
Yeah.
There's no direct path to it. It just flows as water flows. You know what I mean? Mm. There's no constant state of stuck on one thing.
Right.
It'll just fluidly move.
Well, to get a little flavour of what your flow is like, I mean, we're going to talk about the collaboration phase that you've done with Afro, so we're going to talk about Gift of the Mouth. So how did the collaboration with Afro first come about? Because that was a big coup for you.
We met when he came to Liverpool with R.A. the Rugged Man.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
And then before, was it Zanzibar shut down? It was one of the last shows in Zanzi, and I was like, oh, blah, yeah, me, I rap on that. He's like, I've got beats, send me some beats. Then in the very end, he got back to me.
Wow.
And I was just like, yeah, man, let's do it.
So what year would that have been about?
Ooh, 2015, 16 now, maybe.
So at first, did you think he was might have been like one of those?
I've messaged people before and said, do you want to do a track? And so, you know what I mean? I want £300 million to do a verse with you. And he was just so humble, so responsive. He was like, well, I want that beat. I want to do this, that, then. And it's just...
because I'll be honest, when I first seen the collabo credit, I thought... first of all, I thought, props, you've made that link. That's cool.
Yeah.
But then I thought it might have been one of those ones where... the guy's wrote a verse and he's probably putting that verse on like 6 or 7 or 18 other tracks. And then next minute, I am coming in with this like Felcon and Liverpool. And I thought, boy, this is sick.
When I made the beat, I was like, that's an Afro beat. I was like, I want Afro. It was like I visualized that I ripped the hook with his name in it before I even asked him. And
before
I was like,
asked him.
And I just caught, I had to be him.
Yeah.
So the same with the Mike Righteous one. I was like, I've made the beat. This is a Mike Righteous beat. It has to be his verse. Otherwise, it's never going to be complete.
Okay, we're going to talk a little bit more about production in a little bit. But for now, let's get into this. In fact, you can introduce it to the listeners.
Yes, this song is from my first album, Rise of the Wolf King. It's called Gift of the Mouth, featuring Afro, All Flows, Reach Out, produced by Con Lennon.
Con Lennon. L100.
Jeez.
This is yo, yo. Manifest. Shot shifted, gifted, lifted, niggas spit the different quote. Take a split for thick smoke, damn, you dig a nigga fro. Hospital bed rocking, it's off with his head. Bombarded, boat guarded, mo profit, pocket the rest. Don't stop it, bro, for sure, go skyrocket instead. Don't get tired, bong, bong, throw, snap a rifle, you're dead. All trifling, bury the Peter, the Paul, and Apostle. Begging a pardon, roll straight, popping off with the lead. No talking, quiet now, classroom in session. I'm that rude, I'm that dude who demanding attention. Do things mad rude, let it be, I'm rowdy. Wu-Tang cash rules, everything around me. I figured I had to consider the rhyme and the line and the beat. And I'm right on time, I had to defeat the following, let them retreat. The beat to be bombed, step in the scene, yet to be calm. The better I be, the enemy arms ahead of me. Better be ready for war, body to beat.
They wasn't looking heads, I'm twisting them now. I walk like I talk with the gift of the mouth. Rise of the Wolf King, I'm in for the crown. I wait for the moon and I spit with her. They wasn't looking heads, I'm twisting them now. I walk like I talk with the gift of the mouth. Rise of the Wolf King, I'm in for the crown. I wait for the moon and I spit with her. Mathematics, acrobatic. I thought a clap verse would work if I grow spotted. In a shaky tub like a bath with addicts. I have to manage a master plan of my erratic. Well-constructed lyricism, helping up the different living out the structure, rounding up these cowards who corrupted systems. The hours don't know what to pick from. Tally up, don't list some reasons not to switch on. Eradicate the master race, activate your faggot brains. Think for yourself, don't just masturbate, masturbate. Talk about the problems that we have today. Plan a way to save this planet before we're snapped away. I'll call my label the Infinity Saga, a cultivation of six stones, bringing a starter to a whole universe. You can witness be part of Marvel in the studios that we built for some armor. I'm digging these covers while hippity hopping. I did you redo while you didn't do nothing. I'm living through coming, I'm spitting too often to even lose options. I mean to do something, I mean to be jumping. A difference, you bumping, a living, a swimming pool, different through good things. In with a stick of you, isn't that something? There wasn't looking heads, I'm twisting them now. I walk like I talk with the gift of the mouth. Rise of the Wolf King, I'm in for the crown. I wait for the moon and I spit with her. They wasn't looking heads, I'm twisting them now. I walk like I talk with a gift at the mouth. Rise of the Wolf King, I'm in for the crown. I wait for the moon and I spit with her. They wasn't looking heads, I'm twisting them now. I walk like I talk with a gift at the mouth. Rise of the Wolf King, I'm in for the crown. I wait for the moon and I spit with her. They wasn't looking heads, I'm twisting them now. I walk like I talk with a gift at the mouth. Rise of the Wolf King, I'm in for the crown. I wait for the moon and I spit with her.
And that's the sound of Afro, well, Felcon featuring Afro, Gift of the Mouth. And we got a Felcon in the studio, also produced as well.
Yes, yes.
So when did the production things kind of start for you?
Do you know what? Hanging around with Rosh a lot. I used to watch Rosh because me and Rosh, when Rosh was making the Sample Life, everything he'd done, do you know what I mean? It was fresh. So I used to watch him doing it and I was like, get me Fruity Loops. I want Fruity Loops. And then I just took what he taught me and just made it become my own.
Yeah, yeah.
And I used to just go on YouTube, Vinyl Frontier, pull old songs and then just sample from there then.
And when was this about? When did this start?
It must have been about... just before Rise of Wolf King, about a year or two, so about 2016 again, 2015.
So how much, so on Rise of Wolf King, how much of that production is
100%.
100% all yours?
All, every album, wow. It's all me. Rise of Wolf King, Year of the Wolf, Self-Isolation, Rebirth, yeah. It's all me.
And have you produced for other artists as well?
I have, yeah. I've produced for Jamie, Jono, okay. Mike, Afro, Bobby Rex has just done a diss track to one of my beats.
Okay.
So it's kind of like handpicked. Like, yeah. You're not going to kill it, you ain't going to get it.
Now, obviously you represent the Riddle, and we see obviously you're always representing with the Tramier top and stuff. And there's so many artists representing this genre of music now from the Riddle. Obviously, you mentioned Rush, you got, you know, the Jedi Knights guys in Mickey and Dot. Also, you got JR, you know, so JR. Obviously it's a different
Lyric
spin.
Smith as well.
Lyric Smith, of course, and also there's the girls, Tabitha and Eliza, yeah. Who are representing the ladies on the R&B tip. So, but would you say that from the Riddle, is there a different vibe for artists that do this music on the Riddle?
Kind of, but kind of not. I feel like it's all, everyone's isolated in what they want to do.
Yeah.
There's no like, there's not five people doing a certain sound. Everyone's sounds are like, no one sounds like Max. No one sounds like Josh. No one sounds like Mal.
Did mention Mal as
well. Yeah, no one. Everyone individually sounds different.
Mm-hmm.
No one sounds like Juvie.
Yeah.
Obviously, he's a bit more like Elsie, but do you know what I mean? He's still
from that
side of the pond.
Yeah.
So,
of course,
it's all isolated sounds, but it's not like no one's trying to copy each other. Yeah. Do you know what I'm saying?
And do you feel people from the Riddle, artists from the Riddle, get their props, or do you think that there's that?
Yeah, of course we do. I wouldn't be here if we didn't get props.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're always putting us on the 100 Cyphers.
Yeah, yeah.
The shows, Kof bring us all in. So that's just. Yeah. Well, when people say we don't, it's not. We'll get our props. That's a fact.
So we're all part of the same kind of family.
Oh yeah, it's all Merseyside. It's a Merseyside collective.
Definitely. So let's speak a little bit about the new project then, because obviously you've got a couple of projects that are already on Spotify. Obviously you mentioned The Wolf King and the self-isolation one, which obviously that was made during lockdown.
Yeah.
So what's up next for you now?
So there's but I made an album. I've made the full album called Headspace. But in the headspaces that I was in, I made it through just all. I was just drunk. The whole album's all drunk. And if you hear it, it is. You can hear it. So it was called Headspace. And I thought, nah. I listened back sober and I thought, that's not for me. So then I started Rebirth because it felt like a rebirth in my eyes. And then that's where it's all come from.
Really?
Sacked this whole Headspace album off and then just made Rebirth.
Okay.
Every time I make a song off Rebirth, I listen to Headspace, I think, I don't want it to sound like that.
Really? I mean, because obviously you haven't shied away about talking about personal issues.
I know
mental health is something that you've spoken about, not just on tracks, but also, you know, on posts and in conversations. So
yeah, love your life, don't hate to live.
How's the mental health situation affected you? If that's something you can talk about.
Yeah, it's your battle between yourself. You know what you want, your own happiness. Everyone, like you say, the comedian will make everyone laugh and then they'll go home on the train and be sad.
Yeah.
And you can't be happy because you make other people happy.
Mm-hmm.
Then sometimes you've got to make yourself happy, and then music makes me happy.
Yeah.
I've got Connor, I've got Felcon. There's no one person. They both come together to give me something to reflect from.
And how much do you think that music has helped?
Oh, a million percent. I feel like I tell people I've got something that others can't. I can get stuff out through music where other people can't do that. If I feel sad, I can make a song about it. But when my real dad passed, I can make a song about it. Some people can't talk about it.
Yeah. Channel it.
Straight away. If I feel down, I can just make a beat and write a verse about it. And that feel just gone from my body. Then I feel like I can breathe.
That's the amazing power of music.
Amazing power.
So on the new project, there's a track that we've got here that we're going to play. I think I've played it on the show before.
Yeah.
So you give me a little exclusive there, which is always a good thing. I should have a sound.
Always exclusive.
So tell us a little bit about this and then introduce it to the listeners.
This is from me and a guy called DKM90, a guy who I've known for years through America. I met him on Battle App, and he is one of the sickest MCs that no one knows anything about. And it's just a blessing. I hope you enjoy what he comes with, because it made me want to delete my verses.
And the track is called
Not Alone, produced by Connor again.
To be lovely on the streets, everybody jubbly and cuddly, but it seems that we need to be mean. It's the greed for the green in your dreams every night. When you sleep, what do you see? Escape from the realistic place that we exist in. Fate is mere fiction. Take, don't be a victim. Hate will be the difference. Say you believe or didn't. It's a system of confliction that corrupts the kids when all they see is sirens, drugs and violence. A life to be riding's a knife to be hiding. It's nice to be violent. The rights are arriving late to disgrace. What's in place so wild in is all we've got left. AK-47s in the mosh pits. My subconscious, I guess I've lost it. But let's just stay focused on the topics.
They say be free to roam, 'cause you
along with the midgets, a game full of children. What's the world and we uplift it? Rearrange the image, fill it full of spirits. Doesn't matter what the limit, just be putting up with lyrics from the bucket load. In the ocean with 100 flows, should expose these rookie clones, but I don't look to boast. The high roads, looking close, I roam unopposed. Tightrope, could have broke, but I float and flutter. So what's the problem? Where's the solution? Why you squabbling? Why you ooing? Why you wanting? Why you moved in without supplying home improvements to the booth? Then sit back and sick that sick hat, the kicks fat, the snare goes.
Man, I'm in a bracket, you can't spit a vivid with the lyrics, it's an image in a quick
they
rap.
Say be free to
to sit on the throne, and I've been patient, waited in the dark this long and meditated, and I don't need anyone's help for me to take it, and if you think you know what I'm saying, then you're mistaken, I don't wanna rule the kingdom, the power is overrated, get the crown, smash it on the ground and break it, cause ain't no one man deserve that much, it corrupts, you get greedy and it still ain't enough, and if you think that you know me, then you gon' see, you don't know shit, and there's no fee for my skill, ain't no pressure high enough for you to break my will, from the day that I told you to the day that I'm killed, I'll fight for every goddamn thing that I've built.
BKM 90, Falcon, special relationship.
Right, so that is the sound of Falcon
and DKM 90.
Oh yeah. And that's called Not Alone.
Not Alone, yes. Because you are not alone.
So, in fact, I just realised now that you are my first in-studio guest.
I thought you said I was your favourite person. Your heart was, a bit
warm.
We'll get to that
yeah. soon. But you're my first in-studio guest, I think. Cheers. Since before lockdown, I'm sure it is. I've had a few guests on the radio, on the phone, but I've not done it in studio guests. So, given that, then we should do the countdown quiz.
Let's do it.
We're a bit tight for time, so we're going to go straight into this quiz. You've listened to the show before. You know how this works.
I know.
So there shouldn't be any surprise.
Sorry. No fear.
We're still live. Okay, so we're going to get into this right now. Countdown quiz. Falcon, are you ready?
I am ready.
Let's go. Favourite TV show?
I haven't got one.
Favourite food spot?
Sub City by Coves.
Phobia?
Bad MCs.
Favourite Liverpool MC?
Jamie Broad.
If you could collaborate with any rapper dead or alive, who would it be?
Big Pun or Big L.
And if you were sent to Hillbury Island for the next 10 years and you can only have three albums, which would it be?
All my three albums.
Oh, man. That is record time.
Yes.
Even though I let you off with that, I haven't got one, because you genuinely haven't got one, have you?
I don't really watch TV.
Okay. Well, I think that's probably broke all records. I don't think anyone will be able to beat that one in a long time. So pick yourself up. So now we're going to get into a rhyme.
Yo. Before we do this, I'd get in. First time hearing a beat. Produced by my man, Rosh. As always. Always comes with the fire. I see if I can fit what I wrote. Yo, cause it's Falcon. Yo, 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 it's Falcon live on the L100 with DJ Two Kind. We're two kinds of hunters. Claim what you want, but we know you ain't done shit. I look like one man, but rap like I'm hundreds. It's Falcon live on the L100 with DJ Two Kind. We're two kinds of hunters. Claim what you want, but you ain't done shit. I look like one man, but rap like I'm hundreds. It's been a minute, myth, a few hundred spins on if Falcon's back, so relax. Look at their routine, they didn't learn these little nids. Really think they've been observed. Think you kill it with your thicker words. That's a pretty verse, haha, but not very attractive. My rap flow attacks flows, it's max. Leaves your fat lip in madness. To think what I've been doing, still improving with my raps kicks. Wolf King, man of the man, that's a fact, kid. Imagine I'm still here to cause chaos. All for war, ass, my fortune been worn straight off the bat. Let's check it back, let's talk players. What shall we do? There's been some changes kicking it off. I guess I'm soft, but I'm diligent, thinking a lot. There's not a spot you can hit me in the villain, yeah, I'm grinning cause I'm killing them off. And it's in stop, gives a minute while I trigger the box. Vision stiff on the watch, sitting spit on the rocks. Don't be thinking I'm not, and to be giving them props. Stop, 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 I give respect where respect's due. So come out the best is exactly what I expect to. Beats produce five a day, like I get fruits. Find my way on this test as I press through. Heads goosed, but lay the golden eggs. Bend back, disappear like fold the beds. I hold the rest accountable for why I don't invest. in the rhymes. When he reach out, I'm so depressed. I suppose I'm stressed. You thought that you're more, but we know you're less. So you better contact my next of kin, because I'm running across the border.